Welcome to Orientation, Vault Dweller. In today's lesson, we'll be going over defending yourself in a world after complete nuclear annihilation. You might need to vaporize some people or things, so let's make sure that you at least know the science of what's going on. So, Vault Dweller, sorry, I can't talk like that anymore. So, Vault Dweller, I'm sure that you're eager to get back out there into the wasteland and to vaporize some raiders, as you see right there, but we should at least have some kind of understanding of the physics of the laser and energy weapons in Fallout before we do so. First, what does vaporization really mean? There's a big difference between separating all the atoms in a person's body and reducing them to a pile of ash. First of all, atomic bonds are really hard to break. Consider a water molecule with one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms. To break the bonds between the oxygen and hydrogen of just 18 grams of water, you would need to input 920 kilojoules of energy, or about the same amount of energy in the form of work that it takes to stop a small car speeding down the highway at 60 miles an hour, or the amount of energy that comes from blowing up half a pound of TNT. If energy weapons were separating all the atoms in a person's or super mutant's body, then it would take a gargantuan amount of energy. 3 billion joules of it. That's the same amount of energy you'd have to input to melt 5,000 pounds of steel or power armor. But let's dig into that number a little bit like a mole rat to see where it comes from, because most of the energy that goes into vaporizing someone is spent vaporizing that person's water. A pile of ash is devoid of water content, so energy weapons must at least be vaporizing all of that. If the average person is maybe 70% water and weighs 78 kilograms, then on the whole, the average person contains 56 kilograms of water. That's what we have to vaporize. Time for a chemistry lesson. Thinking back to the water molecule again, we have to break both of its oxygen-hydrogen bonds to totally vaporize it. And to do that, we have to insert what's called the bond enthalpy energy, which is the amount of energy you need to insert into a chemical bond to break it. And we know that the oxygen-hydrogen bonds break by inserting 460 kilojoules of energy per mole of these bonds. A mole is a standard measurement defined as the number of atoms in 12 grams of pure carbon 12, which just happened to be 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms, now known as Avogadro's constant, named after the scientist who discovered this constant. Now, using this as a standard measurement, if you take the combined atomic mass of an atom or a molecule like water and add it up, that's how many grams of the stuff are in 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of that stuff. Since hydrogen has an atomic mass of roughly 1, and oxygen has an atomic mass of roughly 16, that means that the water molecule has a combined atomic mass of 18. Yeah. So that means that in every 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd water molecules, there are 18 grams of water. Now, with all that chemistry out of the way, how much energy does it take to vaporize someone like in Fallout? If the average human body contains 56 kilograms of water, we divide this by 18 grams of water per one mole of water to find the moles, which equals a little over 3,000 moles of water. And in every one of these 3,000 moles of water, there are two oxygen-hydrogen bonds, remember back to the water molecule, which means there are roughly 6,000 moles of these oxygen-hydrogen bonds, which, remember, have a bond enthalpy energy of 460 kilojoules per mole. You see where we're going with this. So if you multiply these values out, 6,000 moles times 460 kilojoules per mole, you get a gargantuan amount of energy. 2.8 billion joules of energy, which is like two full lightning bolts. So there you have it, Vault Dweller. With Fallout's energy weapons, you're literally carrying around lightning in a bottle or microfusion cell ready to vaporize raiders. The technology may have changed, but war never changes. Except, wait, no, it totally changed, like, it totally changes. Think of the difference between, like, dropping a nuclear bomb on a city and, like, a bunch of dudes lining up on a hill 10 feet away and shooting each other. Yeah, war totally changes. But because science. Okay, bye. Want more science? Check out my last video on how hoverboards work. Subscribe to Nerdist for more videos. If you want Because Science 2 days earlier than anyone else, head to Vessel at vessel.com/nerdist. And as always, if you have any comments or questions or suggestions for future episodes, you can hit me up in the comments section below. Thanks.